Hello and welcome to Schein Chats. I'm Mackenzie Richter, Vice President of Equipment at Henry Schein for the U.S. Dental Group. Today I'm joined by Dr. Heidi Colt-Farber. She's a board-certified oral maxillofacial radiologist, owner and managing radiologist for Dental Radiology Diagnostics, and the founder of DRDX Doctors, an online 3D radiology educational website. I'm so glad to spend the day with you, Heidi. And
thank you.
Let's get right to it.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me.
Throughout your career, you have witnessed an incredible evolution of cone beam technology. What are some of the trends that you found most interesting?
I think that the technology continues to be more accessible to dentists. And I think that we're definitely seeing improved image quality, less noise. The machines are smaller than they used to be and much more affordable and easier to fit into dental offices. So I think that as far as availability and accessibility, it's much improved over what it used to be. And we're seeing more and more dentists adopting this technology.
Thank you. What are some of the things that you're hearing from some of the other dentists that you work with in terms of, there used to be, I think, a significant fear factor for people adapting the technology, just in terms of what they're able to see and how they diagnose. How are you helping to coach other of your other peers through some of those concerns?
Well, we definitely teach courses, and I would encourage anybody to take an educational course on CBCT if they've purchased one. It's definitely technology that you need to have some additional courses on, which are provided by the manufacturers, which is great. So definitely through the educational component, but also partnering with them as far as letting them know there are oral maxillofacial radiologists like myself that can read their cases. We have been working with certain companies like Dentsply Sirona to actually put a little button in their output section that will go right to my reading site as well. And so we have a great group of radiologists there that are more than happy to help with anything. And we always add additional information in the reports as well so that the dentist can learn from it. So I think partnering with an oral maxillofacial radiologist is really beneficial as far as the liability goes and giving peace of mind to the dentist as
confidence
well.
Too, right? Yeah. Absolutely. What are some of, what are you seeing in terms of early AI technology with cone beam?
Well, I think with cone beam, a lot of this is still in research and development, but we're definitely seeing some amazing progress. And we will get there. In fact, I think it's going to make us very, very busy as radiologists because there's a lot that's not being caught on CBCT. So it will point that out. And I think that will help again with the dentist's peace of mind, as well as that interaction that we have with them day by day. So
when we look at some of those trends, you know, AI and again, growing confidence, taking courses, things like that to really become proficient. What are some of the most impactful trends that you're seeing outside of, again, training, working with someone who's got their, you know, their radiologist degree? What are some of the other things that you're seeing becoming more and more important for dentists?
Well, I think that this is, as it becomes more mainstream, it is utilized every day, especially for implant treatment planning. It's fabulous for endodontics. In fact, knowing what I know now, I don't think that I would do endodontics without a CBCT. It just becomes so integral into the everyday landscape of the dentist that it can be utilized for many different applications. And so I think as far as the trend goes, it's just increased amount of usability for CBCTs.
So I think that's interesting because it's not an insignificant investment. For a practice owner to make. That being said, though, the benefits, obviously, if you're able to see more, you're able to treat better, and you're probably going to be finding some procedures that you naturally wouldn't have. And you're seeing that pretty regularly?
Oh, absolutely.
Across the board?
Yeah. And the improvement in diagnosis is just phenomenal when you go from 2D to 3D.
Mm-hmm.
I think one of the things that always strikes people is, why didn't I do this earlier?
Right.
I should have done this before.
Yes.
And then you go back and you look at your other work and go, ooh, I could have benefited from that.
Yes.
So, I mean, definitely it's just something that is so incredibly useful to be able to see everything in 3D.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, I just, you know, just probably usability.
And then
for everything.
When we kind of flip the lens and look at the patient, what are some of the benefits that you're seeing from the patient's perspective?
Well, from the patient's perspective, obviously their pain is being diagnosed more appropriately.
Mm.
You can actually see what is bothering the patient.
Right.
They're able to see it as well.
Right.
So I think the trust factor is there. You know, I mean, just that decrease in pain, that prompt treatment, the accurate treatment, knowing that that is exactly what's wrong with me. That's huge. I mean, it's so comforting for the patient. But furthermore, you know, in having the entire volume reviewed, they know, okay, I don't have anything else going on.
Right.
They can feel pretty confident with that.
Mm-hmm.
So,
do you find that patients perceive a higher skill level when the technology is being used in a practice?
Yes, they definitely do.
Yeah.
They definitely do. I mean, if you were to go to a dentist to have an implant placed and they just have the 2D versus the 3D where they can show you, this is exactly where I'm putting it.
Right.
We're going to make sure that we avoid any of the pertinent anatomy.
Yes.
That's huge comfort.
Right.
They know exactly what's happening.
Absolutely.
So.
And seeing is believing, right? We oftentimes hear from our dental customers that patients say, oh, I won't go forward with the treatment. But when they're able to see it live in 3D, it makes it so much more compelling.
Yeah, it really does. They can really see. They can take it home. They can show their family members.
Right.
I mean, it really does
really
make it more compelling.
Incredible.
Yeah.
So as someone who reads CBCT images on behalf of other doctors, what are some of the tips that you can give people as they're getting started on their own journey?
Well, number one, of course, take the courses.
Take the course.
We know that only about 60% of the dentists actually take the courses.
Mm-hmm.
So I would highly encourage you, take the courses.
Uh-huh.
They're free.
Right.
They're offered from the manufacturer.
Mm-hmm.
You paid for it already. Take advantage of that for sure.
Right.
But also, we need to understand what we're viewing. And again, part of the educational courses, make sure that we're limiting the amount of motion artifacts that the patient has.
Mm-hmm.
When you have motion artifacts, you can't see exactly what's going on. You can't see those fine details. And I think that's one of the number one things that we see from new dentists in cases that are sent to us is an incredible amount of motion artifacts, but they're not understanding why they can't see what they want to see.
Mm-hmm.
So just being able to understand what it is that you're looking at.
Right.
Very important.
And something so basic.
Something so basic.
Absolutely. Yeah. Now, as we're looking at dental schools, many, many of our dental school students are being exposed to cone beam technology, and they're becoming used to that as a standard of care.
Right.
How do you think that's going to shape and change the landscape of a dental practice going forward?
Well, first of all, the very first thing that they're probably going to see coming out is which dentists are, you know, following the technology and which you're not.
Mm-hmm.
And who are they going to want to work for?
Right.
So they're probably going to want to work for a place that is, you know, on the cutting edge and has the technology.
Absolutely.
Because it's what they're used to using, number one. But number two, it's much more, is easier for them to walk into a practice that already has it, be able to read it and integrate it because they're already used to that.
Right.
They're already using all of that technology.
Right.
And so I think from that standpoint, you know, they already know how to read, basically.
Right.
So
Absolutely.
It makes it much easier.
No question.
Yeah.
Just that that muscle memory
of
using a newer technology. You can't go back. And
and
this is
exactly
my
it.
Final question. I believe I know the answer, but I think it's an important one to ask. If someone came to you today and said, you cannot use this technology, we're going to go back to two-dimensional radiographs, what would that do?
I would feel
personally.
Blind, completely blind, because I know there's a better way.
Right.
And I think that's the hard thing that you want to convey when people are saying, well, I don't know if I should get it or not get it.
Mm-hmm.
It is so immensely life-changing.
Right.
that I would never want to do dentistry without 3D imaging.
Right.
I mean, it just, the profound difference, I can't even express that enough. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So,
I can't thank you enough for your time today. If you don't mind, where can people find you?
Well, I do have my private practices online at dentalradiologydiagnostics.com.
Okay.
And like you said before, we did start an educational website as well. So wanting to encourage dentists, you know, even if you're sitting at home and you don't really have time to go somewhere else, you know, hop online, look at a video. We actually did it in little micro amounts, so you can spend 10 minutes here or there and learn something about it.
So, fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you
for joining us.
I appreciate it.
And I hope this is tremendously useful because it's been very, very valuable for me. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Mm-hmm.